And for anybody to really just come out and speak their piece and, you know, give us an idea of what it is that they're into. This is also kind of like a networking event for people to get to know each other, see how we can help each other in our spaces. Please excuse me if I'm a little bit discombobulated. I actually just came from Minnesota. And we had the nerve to drive out there in the middle of a blizzard and a whole bunch of other stuff, but it was actually pretty worth it. It was like -5 degrees. So this right now, I'm ready to put on shorts and a bathing suit. Like this is.
It's warm right here.
This is like tropical weather to me. But I'm still actually coming off of the high of what I did while I was out there. I actually have been into transformational work since 2017. I started with an organization called Momentum. Now I'm working with the organization called Impact. Pretty much, when we talk about transformational work, it's about us actually as people starting to look at ourselves as individuals, recognizing our traumas and looking to see how these things actually affect us in every aspect of our life. In this particular case, we also included social justice into that. So during that, we were also out there for MLK Weekend. We had a panel with George Floyd's brother, Terrence Floyd. It was very powerful. It was a very interesting type of environment. The one thing that I will say is that it's a space that is in great need of healing right now. It seems like, and I'm just giving you my experience, I really don't have anything written about what it was, I'm just going off the dome, but it seems like when George Floyd died in that space, that the area itself also died along with him. You know, the people there, they're kind of, what can I say? They are, I don't want to say paranoid, I want to say that they're a little wary about outsiders being there because of how many people have came into the space and exploited them. So we went out there to kind of like, you know, also give our, try to start the process of healing in that area with them. And we are now also working with them to see if we can bring healing work into the space so we can start the process of them healing as people, as Terrence, his brother, his healing. Right now, it's kind of like they're looking to place the responsibility on him to heal the space. But what we have come to learn is that we all can play a part in that. This is something that is not only affecting there, obviously. This is something that's happening here in New York and all over. So I guess at this point, what I can say is the biggest thing that came up for me was legacy while we were there. And we all get to choose what our legacy is going to be. We can all sit down and post and you know, fight and cry on social media, but there's a lot of more work that needs to be done when it comes down to the stuff that's been going on in the world right now. So that's, you know, I don't know if I'm making sense. I'm hoping I'm landing it. I'm trying to get it together right now. But all I can say is we all get to play our part in healing this world right now. It is much, much needed. So with that being said, you want to say something?
Yes. You completely landed it, and that's exactly where we needed to be. And that's why Felicia is going to be one of the new hosts of 7-7. So give it up for Felicia. And you see how easy she just flowed into the situation. You guys didn't even know what's going on. You're like, man, she's talking to that. Did 7-7 start? What's happening? What's going on? And that's what this is. We are a community, and we live in Brooklyn. We live in Flatbush, Brooklyn, Crown Heights, whatever you want to say, East Flatbush, whatever. We are very, 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 very lucky. I want to thank all you guys for coming out on this cold AF night. It's amazing that we are like a community slash family here. We get together every 10 days and we talk about what's going on and we share, we network, we build, we support businesses in our neighborhood. That's why we're here tonight. We're here tonight to support Jingling Baby. That's what this whole 7-7 was created for this particular one. Felicia does her lit karaoke here. Carrie, I think you do some comedy here as well. There's a comedy night here. So this is a space. Is there anyone the first time in this space? Raise your hand, please. Okay, that's about, no, it's not your first time in this space, is it? Word, that's at least 15 people for the first time in the space that now know about this incredible establishment. This is what we need to do, folks. If we want to have a great community, is to build, connect, and share. So with that, I'm gonna bid off this mic. We only got 4 people in here, so I understand that like it's tough for people to get here. Some of our performers who were supposed to be on aren't here. So this is a first. So if someone wants to, you know.
Tell them that there's seats down here.
And there's seats down here?
Come on.
We need someone who wants to do the time. Serena, I see you. No, you can't do the time. Serena, you want to do the time? Oh, before we get into, and I'm going to come back to them. Serena, you can you handle it?
She got it.
Serena, can you be tough and be like, when it's a minute to go, they will know? All right. So. All right, let's keep the protocol going. Athena, let's pull this first name. Let's get this thing going so you guys can get home and get warm and cozy. Say what you see as loud as you can.
Zanaya.
I think I wrote it. Well, tell us a story while you're getting ready.
So my name is Zanaya. I am from Louisville, Kentucky. And I've been living in New York for about, it'll be 3 years in May. And in May. And I'm an aspiring singer-songwriter. And there's not like a mic or anything. I'm just like kind of... Okay, I got you. Well, I'll just, I'll sing out loud. I kind of want to do a cover song. One of my favorite cover songs to do, it's called Angel from Montgomery. Originally written by John Prine, and then re-recorded by Bonnie Raitt. And so,
always do. flies in the kitchen. I can hear them, they're buzzing. And I ain't done nothing since I woke up today. How the hell can a person go to work in the morning?
Zynga?
Zynga.
Give it up for Zynga, y'all.
Yeah. Woo! Testing. I'm a virgin here tonight. This is my first time being here. Yeah. All right. I earthicate this to two fighter ancestors who both just passed a few days ago. Former U.S. political prisoner Sekou Odinga.
Yes.
And relentless activist Viola Plummer.
Yes.
Of the December 12th Coalition. Two heavy losses, but they pass on their torch to everyone here in this room tonight. And our youth, our future, our children are our future. Ashe. In a world that cancels the truth or can cancel you, blue will be red and red will be blue. Which political party are you? Partly no more a party than a statement on which dog whistle for white supremacy it will be. A myth that mothers still brainwash their child with. And internet sites recruit young minds that might just become the next. Mass school shooter interpreting internet like school text. We speak calm, but my soul is vexed at the damn nonsense to start a race war over a lost civil war, which already was a race war, call it a slavery war. And it is not a riddle, it was nothing civil. It was barbaric, savage, sick, demonic, sadistic, deranged, and entire people physically ravaged. So go ahead and take black history out of schools. We will never remove our ancestors' blood from this earth. Reparations are overdue, yet can never equal what we are worth. Teach our children, all children, the truth from mistakes of the past to not be repeated. Can you see this? Can you hear this? Accountability must be heard, and that's my word. But this is just something silly I'm writing. I'm flipping, I'm tripping, Mother God is speaking. What should be like? No stress, no strife, health, and wealth. But I roam in shock every day, sick to the bone. I just can't say how hard this makes me feel in my soul. I just want to cut it all short right now today because I know there are many people lined up. And I just want to say thank you to our brother, my brother Rasul Sajafu, for inviting me here. So give it up to everybody here. And I just want to say thank you. Come on.
You got 5 more minutes. So where are you from?
Jersey City, born and raised.
Jersey City. Do poetry all over?
Yes, I have. I actually won the first poetic battle that was done on the Apollo Theater back in the day.
Yes. So she's a newbie. She got 4 minutes. Should we grill her?
No. It is like so freezing cold outside. I didn't even know if this is gonna go on.
Don't be fooled by her beauty. She's a warrior. She will cut you with her words. Trust me. Alright, she will cut you with her words. This woman, we fed homeless people on the street for many years.
Yeah.
She's been on the battlefield. Yeah. She's looking for a good husband, a real husband. No, you gotta get a warrior sister, not a roundaway girl, a warrior. Alright, I'm just putting the baby back. I love you.
But I just wanna say, you know, thank you so much. And you know, we need to realize that when ancestors pass on, like Viola Plummer of the December 12th Coalition, Sekou Odinga, they did so much work. They put this work into their lives. This work was their lives. And they pass on, they're gone, but their spirit is still here. And they are passing their torches on. So we have to pick up where they leave off. We don't look at ourselves as leaders, but we are who we are waiting for. All of us here in this room have the potential to be a leader in our communities, respectively. So I just want to leave you all with that. Take up the torch. Don't ever think that there's nothing in this world that you cannot do because you are awesome. You can do anything that you put your mind to. Our children are our future. Our people shall rise. Reparations is long overdue, but they can never pay us what we are worth. But it's still necessary. Because if Japanese can get reparations and everybody else can get reparations, it's long
Germans.
Overdue for us. Ashe.
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 Germans, Native Americans.
Well, number one, I want to say that was a very powerful message.
Thank you.
And I'm going to tell you right now, there's no mistakes. That message has been something that's been going on this whole weekend about legacy and what we're choosing
love
to
you,
path, pass on, all right? So what she said, please keep that in mind. Everybody can do it, all right?
Yes.
So coming up, Greg.
That's great. Testing. All right, everybody, this is the 17th, if y'all know. If y'all been here before, I'm the 17th. Every 17th, I present a freedom that we reflect on based upon a holiday season that we started called the 17 Days of Freedom, Uhuru Days, which bring attention to Juneteenth, which everybody knows now is Texas's Emancipation Day, but July 5th is New York's Emancipation Day. Most people don't even know that New York had slavery, but New York had slavery longer than Georgia, Tennessee, and many other states. So, but between Juneteenth, June 19th, and July 5th are 17 days, and today I would like to feature one of those freedoms that we celebrated last year. But first, I'm gonna just quickly read, since we have time today. I'm just gonna quickly read just an excerpt about the holiday season. As I mentioned before, June 19th through July 5th, Uhuru season, our 17 days of freedom, is created to commemorate the historical tradition of, wow, what is that? I forgot, I'm older now. I need glasses to read. The historical tradition of celebrating freedom and emancipation among Black Americans between the dates of June 19th and July 5th. The number of days between those two are 17. June 19th represents the day that the last Americans were freed from private enslavement. Slavery never really ended. It just became public. 14th Amendment, you guys look at it. July 5th represents the day that Black Americans, especially prior to the Emancipation Proclamation, historically celebrated American independence as a socio-political protest to the continued enslavement of people. Any of you guys know Frederick Douglass's speech, What to the Slave is the 4th of July? That was written during a July 5th celebration that happened quite often in New York. For each of the 17 days, we acknowledge and celebrate a particular freedom that was prohibitive of enslaved people to imbibe. Today's freedom, because this is our first 7-7 where we invite the community, I just want to stay in the spirit of what, you know, our great leader, Miles.
Not a leader, we're one community, I am not a leader.
One community, but our great visionary. Let's say that. We're gonna give you some solid.
All right.
Our great visionary. You know, he really wants to stress that, you know, we come together, we create community. And so please take this moment before you leave to get to know somebody new before you leave. And so today's freedom is the freedom to honor and celebrate community with family and friends. 7 seconds of silence just to reflect on the freedom to honor and celebrate community with family and friends. Thank you.
I know a lot of us hate Will Smith because of what he did to Chris Rock, and so we protest that movie. But what did you see that movie, and what did you think about it?
Was it which movie?
Emancipation, the movie Emancipation. It's a true story about the brother with the...
Right, it yeah. is. I mean, to be honest, I only saw half of it.
Yeah.
So I wasn't really familiar. I was familiar with the story.
Okay.
I think...
If you didn't see the movie, it's a true story about the brother. I know his first name was Peter, and his picture is world famous. He's sitting down with the wealth from the whips on his back. You know, forget about Will Smith and his ignorance. Go see the movie and learn something about somebody who went through hell and actually get up and fight again.
I see.
Yeah.
I just want to contextualize a little bit about what Greg presented, because I'm not sure if everyone understands. He has created a situation where we're celebrating the 17 days between 4th of July and July 5th. Those 17 days between Juneteenth, the 19th of June, and July 5th. That's his understanding and creation that none of us thought about. I did not know what he's shared with us, but now I do. And so those 17 days between that are very important. And think about that. Back in the day, folks didn't even have the right to do what we're doing right now. To be with their family and community and celebrate in a space. Like, this is amazing. And thank you for making us aware of that. And the part of the beauty of 7-7, what we've all created here, is that we do actually get together like a family every 10 days. Every 10 days we gather. And I'm piggybacking off of what they both presented, because there's this new movie coming out called Origin.
That's right.
Have you heard about it?
Absolutely, Miles.
Okay, I just learned about it. But what it makes me think about is that all of us, every single one of us in this room, are simply the product of your mom and your dad, and your grandma and your grandpa, and you keep going back and back and back and back. And now we are the manifestation of whoever those people were back then. We are, and so we have to unpack all of the stuff that happened to your grandfather and your grandfather and back and back and back. Some of them probably were on one side and some of them were probably on another side, but now we're here and we're coming into these understandings. So I haven't seen Origin, but it seems to me like it's 2024 and there's a whole lot of awakening happening. And I think us in this room, simply because we're in Brooklyn, simply because we convene consistently, we're like the tip of the spear. So the closer we get and the stronger our community gets, the better things will be, the more we will unpack all those different things. That's my 5 minutes. Thank you, Jay.
You ready for the next one, you want to write? Good evening. How you all doing?
Irie.
When I said Ja, let me hear you say Rastafari. Ja?
Rastafari.
Ja?
Rastafari.
Beautiful, beautiful. Yeah, other name goes is Rastakura. You know, and I like to introduce myself as a dub poet from Jamaica, you know? You know, dub poetry. When the spoken word meet the reggae rhythm and the dancehall rhythm, we call it dub poetry. See, so that's a style of poetry that Rastakura and what if others before I and I bring forth in this time, right? But we're going to a poem that is entitled Heirloom Seeds Exchange, right? Because we realize the danger of GMOs, and we also realize that as a farmer, there's a particular position that we have to take in the earth, you know? And which is to inform the people and educate the people through the spoken word. And it's also one of the reasons why we host the annual poetry festival in Jamaica. See, on the last weekend in April, Ras Osage, who was there in Jamaica last time, right, on the grounds of the College of Agriculture in Portland, Jamaica, which is also on the side of a beach. And we host an annual poetry festival, spoken word, and seeds exchange. So we invite the farmers to bring their natural seeds and trade seeds among each other, right? So this poem is entitled Seeds Exchange. Me plant heirloom seeds in the earth, and the ganja plant start to grow. Ganja maker, ganja planter, Rastakura, ganja maker. Me plant heirloom seeds in the earth, and the ganja plant start to grow. So me say, seeds exchange from gate to gate, parish to parish and state to state. Join the pollination, far, see food's direction in a time of plastic foods invasion. Save seeds and keep the strain alive. Jamaica is known for a variety of natives. I am Jamaica Indigenous Heirloom Seeds Exchange movement. I am the heritage of the heirloom strain. To preserve me, man will live again. Because a seed that has been genetically modified actually lose its ability to reproduce. So each time the farmer wants a new stock of seeds, he must return to that source to purchase new seeds. When traditionally a plant is supposed to produce food and seeds, and you eat the food and save the seeds for replanting of the next crop. But what is happening now when I purchase seeds in the seed stores is that majority of the seeds are GMO, are contaminated with some form of genetic modification. Then through cross-pollination, which is the natural means by which plants carry out sexual reproduction, you have the natural vital organic species of the earth becomes contaminated and bastardized. So make a plant heirloom seeds in the earth and make the ganja continue to grow. Make a plant heirloom seeds in the earth, light up the fire and burn GMO.
Okay.
Yes.
Seeds exchange is ancient African tradition. Seeds exchange is from day one, as agriculture is man's first occupation. Just as him start to think, say, he want food for name. But now, to exchange seeds in certain countries is an illegal weapon. So me tell Jamaica, make we practice this seeds exchange in every district. Stop serve the youths them cheese tricks. Avoid the use of modified cannabis. Eat more greens, sit no dead. Ital vegetation, the Rastaman meds. Make it habitual. Every time you eat a fruit, you save a seed.
Yes, I understand.
A minute and a half. Can I get a half a glass of water, please? Half glass of water for a minute and a half. Or a bottle of water, please. So, yeah, I'm not going to too much with the time. What I'm going to do, I'm going to use the opportunity to invite you all, right? This Sunday, right? When I'll be having like an hour and probably 45 minutes, or an hour to perform for you guys, right? So inviting you this Sunday at 8 p.m., get open from 7 p.m. It will be on Church Avenue, between Church and Schenectady. Hold on, let me get the information correct. 4609 Church Avenue. See? And I'm going to ensure that everyone gets a flyer before you leave here tonight.
Yes, sir.
I'm inviting you all. Jamaica, the last Sunday in April, Father Rastakura on Instagram. RASTAKURA. See? Rastakura 1. RASTAKURA. And let us keep the vibration and the energy of the poetry, the heirloom seeds exchange. See? And just remember Rastakura say, burn GMO.
Burn GMO. That
means the burn GMO.
Burn GMO.
Rastafari, I love the island. Selassie,
I got some farmers in here.
I'm going to say this to everyone. He's really from Jamaica. He live in Jamaica, just visiting, just passing through. Humble, making his moves. He's a one man soldier against Monsanto in Jamaica. Alright, get information from Beach. What we do, we have this, it's a seed exchange, and you can, at this festival, you get the best high grade, what you call it, heirloom ganja, not this stuff that they're plant nowadays. Alright?
Alright, give it up, y'all. Woo!
You're not off the hook, Trisha. Come on. Number one, get one.
Yeah, one.
Oh, okay.
And
you got
the fastest hook.
I tell everything. Well, I mean, someone like show the rest of the world while I'm going to pop me this up.
Facebook Live or live, you know? Kari. K-A-R-I.
Yeah,
that's
me.
Yes.
Hello. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hey. It's all the creative sharing, everything. That's amazing. Bringing the energy. It's awesome. Speaking of Juneteenth, I'm actually from Texas. So, so they actually celebrated it, yeah. They're trying, you know, they're really trying. We have like MLK Boulevard. We have an MLK Boulevard in Houston. It just crosses Confederate Way, so that's what we call intersectionality down south. It makes civil rights more less. Whatever you like, you know, depending on the neighborhood. It's cool. It's cool. I'm kind of new to New York City as well. Thank you. Thank you so much. I love it. I feel like New York City has turned me into like an adventurer. Like every time I leave my house, I don't know where I am gonna end up. You know, I'm like trying to avoid puddles. I'm like peeing outside. It's cool. They don't have public restrooms. It's so crazy. We love to talk about how social we are, and we don't have bathrooms. That's fine. I'm a bathroom advocate. That's what my time here is for. It's cool. No, I am from Texas. I grew up a bit of a sporty gal, you guys got the vibe.
Oh, yeah.
That's what they would call you before they call you gay. They'd be like, hey, I heard you were looking for a husband. I was like, me too, just kidding, no. Anybody in here looking for a husband? Because I'm a great wingman. Or person, I know, it's fine. Person, that's cool. I'm not non-binary, although I am fiscally a man. And socially a lone wolf, I am. By that I mean I am a software engineer, but I am the only non-Indian. It's cool. I am a lone wolf on my team. I try to do what I can to relate to them, you know, because I feel like we're a team, we're all one company, you know, and I'm watching cricket. Anybody here watch cricket? Crickets for cricket. No, we have people that watch cricket. It's cool. I like cricket. It's fun to watch as a sport because it's like Great Britain versus all of the countries that it colonized, you know? Like every single match is just a fight for independence. And you know how they mean business because they show up in those polos, just business casual. It's wild. I feel like at the end of the World Cup, the Brits should just be like, hey, you can take any artifact from our museum, okay? You have earned it, you get it back. Take it home. I'd be like, hey, can I have a soccer player back? That'd be great. They go to get that money. I understand. It's fine. I did grow up pretty sporty. That's actually like why I got to go to like private school when I was younger. I got to go because I had a tennis scholarship. Yeah, it's cool. And let me tell you a secret. It's very easy to be the best when all of your competition has asthma. It's true. It turns out you gotta be able to return the air to your lungs. That's actually the most important return of the game. I was hot shit until I went to the public school league and then I lost. So now you know how it goes. Catholic school league. It's fine. I did like going to my school. It was predominantly white. Probably need to say that, right? That's redundant. Learned that word there though. So fantastic education. Great SAT scores, it's cool. The only thing though that would bother me was that like whenever we would play make-believe scenarios, they would only let me play like the black girl character.
Yeah.
You know what I mean, right?
Yeah.
So this was early 2000s, right? So we would play Harry Potter. Can you y'all tell me who the black girl character was in Harry Potter?
Hermione.
No, she was not. We all sitting saw the same movie, all right? That was not a little black woman. Yeah, that was a little white woman. There was none, which is crazy because like if any movie is gonna have a magical Negro, you would think it would be Harry Potter, right? Like, that's their whole thing, right? So I complained to these kids and I was like, hey, you guys have got to give me a character to play. And they said, all right, let's say a new student comes to Hogwarts. And then you can play her. And I was like, dope, who's this new student? And they said, Whoopi Goldberg. Yeah, right? Because it was the early 2000s. And that's the black actress they knew. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, like 12-year-old Carrie wasn't looking forward to playing Harry Potter and the Curse of the Color Purple. Like my room was actually for sleeping, that sucks. That's not fun, you know? It's cool. I do like how representation has been growing in movies a lot more. It has, like, all across the board. Like, did any of y'all see the new Matrix?
Yeah.
Did you like it?
Yeah, I loved it.
It was pretty good, right? I liked it a lot. Because you know what? It was like, hell yeah, let trans women make bad movies too, okay? Because that movie sucked, dude. Compared to the original Matrix, it was trash. That's fine, though. It's cool. I like movies. It is true. It's very true, though. It's facts. It's like, yes. You can look it up on IMDb. It's the worst. It's like, damn, you're going to wait until you become women to put this out? It's fine. It's cool. Like I said, supporting gal. I am married to a woman. Thank you. Yeah, I've been married like almost 8 years. Woo. I know, child bride. It's cool. We are in what they call like the 7-year itch period, which is when you both go through bed bugs. That is, that's how it goes. Anybody else in here have bed bugs ever? Statistically speaking, somebody else in here is lying to me. You're lying. It's crazy. Bed bugs are crazy because like the whole thing is like they're just like having a club on your body. I don't know. Like, have you guys? It's kind of like, have you guys seen Blade? Like movie Blade? Well, have you seen the intro, right? When there's the vampire club and they're just like jamming in the vampire club, right? And they're just going hard. And then all of a sudden, like the sprinklers open and blood starts coming out and they start going even harder. That's what bed bugs do. That's what they look like. On your body, that's fine. Well, we got no Wesley Snipe fans in here. What are we, the IRS? In fact, those billionaires, right? It's fine. Oh, yeah, 1 minute. Oh, well, before I wrap up, my name is Carrie Burt. I run a show downstairs in the basement here every first and third Wednesday. And we try to bring comics from all over New York City to come down here. We've had people who write for Showtime. We have people who write for like a Daily Show. We've had an Emmy Award winner downstairs in the basement before. I know, you didn't even know about it. We're here every first and third Wednesday. That's why I'm here to deliver it. And I got one more thing for y'all. Do you guys like improv?
Yes.
Y'all like improv? Okay, cool. So I take improv, one black in your class, every scholarship, let's go. And one of the things I learned how to do was I learned how to freestyle rap. So I'm gonna leave with something musical. If y'all can just give me a 3 words suggestion, I will freestyle rap and then I'll leave.
Fun, love, play.
Fun, love, play. Let's go for it. Our fearless leader has spoken. All right, are we ready? All right, we're gonna get a clap going like a...
Is it on? We just started performing live at the beginning of 2023. We had a huge year, 23 shows, and some of them were here at 7-7. Thank you all for your support. And we just want to let you know that
we have a show on Friday at Midwood Flats, which is fun. Usually it's kind of far away, so you guys should come. It's free. Get some drinks, support Midwood Flats. And we have an EP coming out on Friday too, so we'll be celebrating that.
Midwood Flats Friday night. I'll be there. The next 7-7 will be at Fiona's.